From Dan, when doing structured walks, do I allow sniffing and marking? What is the best thing to stop and things to allow?
No, Dan, haven't you seen my fucking videos? Where have you been, buddy? Come on, Dan. No. What I want you to do is this. Structured walk is structure. No pee time, no sniffing. Now, if the dog's got to drop trowel and piss and it puts the brakes on, you let it do it. But no, the walk is the walk. We're working. You're at your desk. You're working. Get off your fucking phone on Facebook. Don't be freaking getting on Tinder, okay? You do that during your breaks. You do that before work. You do that after work. Right now, I need you to work. I need you to be productive. The number one theft right now with employees and companies is time. So what I want you to do is this. We're going on a mission. We're going. At my left side, at my right side, no nose on the ground. Let's go. Next. Hey, everybody. How are you? Good evening. Welcome to the show. What would Jeff do? It is, what night of the week is this? Monday night already? It's a Monday night show. It's, I have no idea what the date is. I think we're in January. So how's everybody doing? Let me give you a quick little spiel so that we can jump in the show because Monday nights are only a one-hour show. Thank you, everybody, for showing up. For everybody that's on Spotify, SoundCloud, on the Google platform, on iHeartRadio, on Alexa, thank you so much for listening. Everybody that's watching live on YouTube Live, welcome. Thank you so much. My name is Jeff Gellman. I've got a training center in Providence, Rhode Island. We specialize in aggression rehab and behavior modification. We're obviously we do basic obedience as well, but our big thing is stopping unwanted behaviors. So people are drawn to this show because they want help stopping unwanted behaviors. Most dog trainers out there, probably 90% of them actually don't do that. Believe it or not, they all do obedience as they should. That is the job requirement. But stopping something, they're usually not good at. Aggression, very small percentage do that. So I'm going to use the word punishment a lot. A couple of words I'll use here. Punishment. Punishment is not mean. It's not abuse. You're not mad. You're not angry. You're not upset with your dog at all. You're not yelling. You're not screaming. It's just matter of fact, you can't do that. Don't do it again. The only way to stop an unwanted behavior is through the proper application of punishment. If anybody tells you any different, they're full of shit. They're lying to you. They're deceiving to you. And it's unethical. So Linda will ask the questions. This is Linda. We're married. She asked the questions.
We're married?
The only thing she knows about dogs is 1 hour a week. That's it. This is her involvement with the dogs. So she asked the question. I give the answer.
You didn't talk about super chats though either.
I'm going to get there.
Okay.
Okay. And what we'll do is...
See, I like to tell him what to do.
Meanwhile, we have a short show tonight. So meanwhile, what happens is that most people need a way longer answer than this. Also, I'm just giving everyone just a little bit of tidbit of help here. You really need a full-blown answer, which I also do on my Patreon channel and my Skypes and things like that. There is a dollar sign right underneath your say something, your chat box down there. That's something that YouTube has set up for creators like myself to throw us a little bit of cash. But the cool thing about that is your question goes to the top of the queue. Everything from $4.99 and up goes to the top of the queue. Anything less than that, I know why it doesn't. It's just as important to me. If you give us a dollar, that's just as important. And then you don't have to wait for your question to be answered. So Linda, let's start the show.
This one's from Dan. Recently rehomed one-year-old dog started using Bonker and he's responding better to no, but he can't seem to resist the temptation of same behaviors. What do you suggest to help stop impulsiveness?
So it's possible that you're bonking not firm enough or also switch to a remote collar. Also have the dog on a leash and give it a little bit of guidance. So, you know, and then I would need an example of exactly what you're trying to stop. Next.
Next is from Beverly. Leash reactivity towards other dogs much improved, but there's still some hyper-focusing and whining. Correct hire?
The hyper-focusing, the whining... The shrapnel effect of whining might just go, of your training might just have the whining going away. And the whining is not the worst, but the hyper-focus though, you got to break that concentration. How high do you go? High enough for the dog to go. I'm not looking at that. Next.
Chuck. I adopted a one-year-old terrified feral chihuahua and he is loose in my house. What is the best way to catch him and where should I start with getting him settled in?
Well, Chuck, I mean, hopefully you've caught him by now, right? So, get off the fucking show and go get your goddamn dog, right? Before he shits and pisses everywhere.
Those things can be elusive, though.
Yeah, they also can get away from you. What I want you, and you can't catch them. This is what I want you to do. The dog's living on a leash. It has a leash on almost at all times. Not in the crate, but When it's out, but in the crate, you put a leash on it when it, in order for it to come out, it's always has a leash. That dog should be in lots and lots of structure. Just to let you know, love and affection won't fix, and I hate to use the word fix, a feral dog. I've worked with truly feral dogs. So the chances of a Chihuahua being feral, though, it's probably more fearful. Feral dogs are also fearful, but a feral Chihuahua is possibly unlikely because that means the dog was left to its own devices to survive in the wild. And Chihuahuas don't do well in that situation. They would die because they're going to be pretty low down on the food chain because of their size. So, but either way, it doesn't matter. You've got a loose dog in your house. Where do you start? By keeping a leash on it, crating it at night, crating it when you're not home, run it through all of its obedience commands, watch out for the love and affection, use its food drive if it has it. If it takes food easily, it ain't that feral then. And just watch all of our do-it-yourself videos. Start with healing and place and sit and down and hold the dog accountable and kennel up and come back out and always have it on a leash and always have it, you know, just bring it around with you. Always hold it accountable. Next.
Got a top chat, buddy.
Top chat for $5 from Steve. Steve, no question underneath that. Maybe asked it below. Some people get confused. We'll take the $5. Thank you very much. We use that money for date night, guys. Full disclosure, super chat money. It doesn't save dogs' lives. It doesn't go for like dog toys or chews or dog food. We don't put it towards the medical expenses for dogs at all. And we don't send it away to some nonprofit. We use super chat money for date night for us. That's it. 100% of it. Next.
This one's from Dan. Oh, this is continued. It says, also, he can be very pushy and disobedient. For instance, training with treats, he's great, but take them away and unresponsive to commands. How can I improve on this?
So, yeah, so that's the downfall of food is they do it for food, which means your dog knows it. So now it's time to get rid of the food and go to punishment or compulsion. So or else you will have a selective listener or a stubborn dog. Selective listeners, lack of motivation. Stubborn dog is lack of motivation. If your dog knows down, if you've done down a couple hundred times, and if you say down and your dog doesn't down, but if you whip out a treat or a food morsel and your dog flies to a down, your dog has trained you. It has literally trained you. So now it's time to hold the dog accountable where you would say no leash pop or no remote collar stim, have a leash on the dog. So you still have to teach the dog what no means. So that's what it is. Pushiness, snidiness, it's time for a little bit of compulsion. We got a $10 top chat on that from Susan. Susan, thank you very much. Again, no question, but maybe you wrote it below. Some people just want to just throw us 10 bucks because they appreciate the thousands of free videos that we've put out there. Next.
Okay, this one's from Jordy.
Hey, Jordy.
Have heard you say you're against dog parks and meeting other dogs on walks and looking for the best way to socialize my 4-month GSD. Now his hair stands when people try too hard to come near him. Strangers, never family.
Okay. You said the magic words. Try too hard to come near him. Biggest mistake that you can make. Doesn't make you a bad person. That's why you're here. Don't let strangers come up to your dog. That's not socializing. That's putting undue pressure on a 16-week-old dog or any dog, and that's the best way for the dog to lose trust in you and other humans. So what you do is you tell people, what you do is you have your dog around lots of people. So I'm a huge fan of having your dog around dogs, around people, not necessarily always greeting them. Especially a stranger. I would never have a stranger just come up and pet my dog. Now, what I have done with young puppies is I'll do protocols, stranger protocols, where I'll just go, I'll use a clicker, I'll use food, and I'll make sure my dog has been clicker conditioned and it understands what the clicker is. And I'll say, hey, you want to help me train my dog? Okay, come on over here, stand in front of my dog. And my dog stands in front of the dog, click, food. The dog goes, oh, this is pretty cool, right? So I get paid every time if someone comes up to me. That's how you start it. But the concept of somebody, a stranger reaching over and petting your dog, nope, don't do it. Don't do it. Another top chat for $4.99 mm-hmm. from Chuck. Actually, he is loose without a collar. I took it off stupidly. Do I just corner him to capture? Yeah. Yep, you do, Chuck. Grab a blanket.
Couldn't he make like a little lasso with the leash and kind of get it over the dog's neck?
But like you said, those chihuahuas are elusive.
Yeah.
So what you do is get yourself, you corner it and you grab it. You might get bit though. So be prepared. So get some oven mitts on or some welding gloves on, or just take a blanket, corner it, throw a blanket over the dog. Don't keep it over the dog. The dog will die unless you want to freaking get rid of your dog. It's a good way to suffocate a dog. But you'll do that.
We're not
recommending that or encouraging that at all. And then you would scoop up the dog, put it in a crate, start from scratch. Yes, start from scratch. Next.
You got another one.
From Susan. Nope, the same one.
What about this one on the left?
Oh, from John. Sorry. Hey, John. Hey, guys. Been watching your vids for about a week. Ordered a prong collar and made 3 bonkers the day I found you. And just ordered a knee collar and convinced her from your website. That's 1 of 2. We'll see the next part of the question down below probably. Awesome. Good job, John. John, I like how you're taking action. Next.
Okay. Rob, it's a stretch for my dog to get her nose up to the level of our counters while we cook. Would a quick draw from a handy squirt bottle be okay instead of a bonker?
If you want to, I prefer a bonker. First of all, what I would do is I wouldn't have your dog anywhere near the kitchen counters. So punish that. No, punish. And then tell your dog to be in place whenever you're in the kitchen. Next.
Okay. This makes me cold reading it. This is from Lil Mama Mud. Hello, from cold ass Canada. Negative 36 wind chill, negative 53 tonight. Starmark Pro Prong Collar PVC Type 1 is working a heck of a lot better for us.
Awesome.
Hi, Linda. Thanks for sharing your husband's mind with us.
Awesome.
My pleasure.
That's cool. Good for you. Mm-hmm. Next.
Hey, dog. Hello. Thank you for another show.
Awesome. My pleasure. Next.
From Dan, when doing structured walks, do I allow sniffing and marking? What is the best thing to stop and things to allow?
No, Dan, haven't you seen my fucking videos? Where have you been, buddy? Come on, Dan. No. What I want you to do is this. Structured walk is structure. No pee time, no sniffing. Now, if the dog's got to drop trowel and piss and it puts the brakes on, you let it do it. But no, the walk is the walk. We're working. You're at your desk. You're working. Get off your fucking phone on Facebook. Don't be freaking getting on Tinder, okay? You do that during your breaks. You do that before work. You do that after work. Right now, I need you to work. I need you to be productive. The number one theft right now with employees in companies is time. So what I want you to do is this. We're going on a mission. We're going. At my left side, at my right side, no nose on the ground. Let's go. Next.
Okay. This is from Hey Dog. Yep. A friend asked if the bonker needs to make contact with the dog or if going near it will work as well. Mostly bad aim from across the room.
So the first time you do it, you want to nail the dog right in the head. It's a cotton towel, guys. It's a bonker. All right. You say, I've got a video on how to make it and how to use it. What you're doing is you're loading up the word no. You're making the word no have huge value. So you're not just throwing shit at your dog. You're saying no. Boom. Hard. And then, if the dog's doing some assholery across the room and you say no and you whiz it, it'll probably work. Next. But practice on your aim. Practice. Set up a little anything. Set up a little toy or a little box across the room and literally practice throwing. Next.
This one's from Carl. Should a pup be a certain age before introducing an e-collar to the training regimen?
Carl, good question. You can start a dog at 14 weeks old, but you're not doing it at high levels. You're not doing it for punishment. You're literally doing it in conjunction with all your food training. You're just getting dog used to the stim. You're getting the dog used to the stim. So to us, tools aren't the last choice. They're the best choice. $5 top chat from Paraz. 11-month-old German Shepherd dog just started using the educator, using it at 30 with a boost of 30 for punishment. He doesn't feel much lower. Lower levels, is it too high? Check fit and make sure you're using the longer prongs, the longer contact points. You might need the thick fur contact points. I would check fit. And what you should see is on your German Shepherds, historically, you'll either see muscle movement there, but you can see muscle movement right there as well. Next.
Next one's from Dan. Do you come to the UK for seminars? Do you have any plans to do so?
I was in England and Scotland last year. I probably won't get there in 2019, but yes, I will get back. Next.
Next one's from Jessica. Can a bonker be used to stop barking?
Hell yeah. Damn right. Bark, bark, bark. No. Boom. Guess what? Dog, number one, you're teaching no. Absolutely use it for barking. Any behavior you want to stop, you can use it for. Next.
This one's from Nesta Dog. Hi, wanting to know, how do I get my husband more involved in training? All he does is yell, doesn't want to give the dogs any structure or direction.
Blowjobs. Bottom line, it's a dude. We'll do anything for oral. Anything. Next.
This one's from Kristen. Hold on, let me make sure I didn't skip any. Okay. Hi, Jeff. Is it unfair to my dog to purposefully leave my shoes out, not directly offer them to him so that I can catch him chewing them and punish him for it?
No, that's how you do it. You set the dog up. Absolutely. That's how you do it. You should be able to leave your shoes out. So what do? Leave them out, wait in the wings for your dog. Boom. Remote cower. And if anybody struggles with that, it's like, no, your dog could die. Or your dog, at the minimum, your dog destroys your shoes. This concept of like keeping all the shoes away and keeping all the socks and all the underwear and all the stuff. No, how about this? You're a dog. You're living in my home. Yes, we have to do some dog proofing of the house, but also it's like, listen, okay, I'm not type A. No, I'm leaving my shit. You know, I'm not a slob, but it's like, come on. No, you're going to have to figure this out, dog. Next.
Laura says, hey, Jeff and Linda.
Hey.
Melinda. Hi, Jeff and Linda. Good evening.
Hey, Melinda. How are you?
Jaina. Hey, Jeff. Big fan.
Jaina. Love it.
Mike. Hey, guys. My Griffin requires special grooming involving hand stripping, pulling out the hair.
Yes.
Can you suggest protocol for me to get her comfy with the process?
Mike, not my level of expertise. Talk to a groomer. It's probably going to be a combination of the act of hand stripping, a clicker, and food. And then also, you can use a bonker for any nonsense. I would talk to a groomer that works with some of these dogs. I bet you they got every tip, trick, secret in the book. Next.
This one's from Hey Dog. What is a reasonable expectation for training reactive dogs? My biggest dream is to go to off-leash backpacking again without stressing about a dog coming towards us and my dog becoming reactive.
So Hey Dog, that's a really good question. I mean, that would be my goal as well. Every dog has a ceiling. The thing that's really cool about that is dogs are usually less reactive off-leash than they are on-leash. If you remote collar train the dog and the dog becomes proficient on the remote collar and the dog understands what the word no means and it has a good level of obedience, especially recall, and you can stop all the nonsense really, really quick, then I don't see why not. If your dog is aggressive and gets into dog fights, you probably shouldn't do it. Next. But there's a huge difference between reactivity and aggression.
Laura says, husband said we can come to Vegas if I behave myself.
Well, there goes that fucking deal.
What kind of talk is that anyway?
Laura behaving herself in Vegas? Ain't gonna happen. Tell him what he needs to hear, Laura. Tell him what he needs to hear. Why would you want your wife to behave herself in Vegas? Or why would you want your wife to behave herself anywhere? It's like, we'll straighten
up. You want me to behave myself?
No, I don't. All right, next. Hold on, $5 top chat. Masica, thanks for doing what you do. Masica, thanks for showing a little bit of financial love there. I appreciate it.
Next. Jaina, my dogs play fight very aggressively, but will listen to me if commands should... What? Oh, sorry. But will listen to me if when... I can't even read
okay,
it. What commands should I allow? I don't know.
This is the thing. Now, I let my dogs play fight with each other. With each other, not other dogs. I know exactly where it's going, and it ain't going anywhere. And then I'm like, enough. And they immediately stop. Got it? But you got to train enough. It's not a magic word. So if it ever leads to a fight, I don't recommend doing it at all. I don't recommend doing it all. Next. Okay. Hold on. We got a couple of top chats here. $4.99 for Melvin. Hi, German Shepherd dog afraid of backyard after high stim punishment for fence fighting. I know. He seems afraid of backyard and does not want to go to the backyard anymore. Bring him out on a leash. Hang out with him. Do some engagement games like chuck it, some food training, things like that. At least you stopped. The dog just generalized the shock. Don't worry about it. Your dog will get over it. Bring him out on a leash. It works. Next. Oh, well, hold on. We got another top chat. Mm-hmm. $10 from John. Here's question two. He's the one that made the bonker, got the pet convincer, got the prong collar. I have an 8-month-old Rotsky, and long story short, good, because you only got so many fucking letters here. Holy hell, it's worked wonders. Next time you tell someone to just do it, could you imitate Shia LaBeouf for me? Just do it. I don't know. Do you know who Shia LaBeouf is?
Shia?
I don't know who these people are.
You don't know who that is?
No, I have no idea.
Okay.
So I'll tell you what, I will watch
it. Because you're living in like a century or a generation.
I'm 53, I guess. I guess I'm just out of it, right? Okay. I will look up the video and I will try to get the person. I don't even know if it's a male or a female.
It's a guy.
It's a guy.
Yeah.
I will try to do it. I will try to do that. So I can sound just like him. Next. Proud of you.
Okay.
We got a lot of questions. We got to blow through these.
Tiffany, tonight. Hi guys. How close is your house to your training center? Is there someone there with the dogs 24 hours a day? Thanks for all the good stuff.
1.3 miles away. And we have 24 hour staff. And there's three people that currently live there. Next.
This one's
because they get free rent. Next.
Lynn. I'm not sure what this question says. When Don E. Kirsten Mattson's husband. And it doesn't make any sense.
So what it is this is the woman who asked about how to get her husband on board. And now Lynn is saying when she's done, work on her adult sons. The problem with that is, Lynn, do you remember what suggestion I gave her to do with her husband?
Whoa.
I don't think you want Lynn performing oral on your sons. So, but
I can't even believe you're saying this.
But
this is outrageous.
But let me go back to the real truth. You sit down and you ask, first of all, you shouldn't have to convince any family member to be on board. They should want to be on board. The bottom line is, if the husband or if your kids don't want to be involved, fine. But please don't self-sabotage the training that I'm doing. That's all I ask. But you can also say, hey, this is a problem, especially dangerous behaviors. It's a problem. You know, or you're going to have to pick your battles. Next. Oh, wait, hold on. $4.99 top chat. Yep. Hey, dog. Just because you both are special and lovable, have a good date night. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, dog. Thank you. $10. We already did that one from John. Yep. Next.
Ray, some people say to exercise the dog before training obedience. Do you think it's necessary or does the training count as mental exercise?
Ray, that's a cop out. No. I don't want an exhausted dog when I'm training it. I want my dog to be on fire because why? I want my dog to listen when it's like, doesn't want to be listening. Does that make sense? No, I'm a huge advocate of structured exercise. Okay, I'm talking about punishment a lot because I'm being asked very specific questions. But if you're brand new to my world, I'm a huge advocate of structured exercise. I'm a huge advocate of dogs doing dog sports or a task or work. I'm a huge nutrition. We feed raw. You don't have to feed raw. I'm a huge advocate of training your dog on all the basic obedience commands and some advanced stuff if you want to, on leash and off leash. I'm a huge fan of taking your dogs as many places as possible and socializing them. So, but to train, you don't need a tired dog. No, I want the dog to be like the dog. That's a cop out, I think, for a lot of trainers that don't know how to apply punishment. And the dog's always aroused. You can stop arousal instantly, though. Next.
This one's from Kion, I think. Yep. You say it like that. My dog gets aroused when we train with food. Should I switch to verbal praise?
Downfall of food, yes. Or make sure your verbal markers are just neutral, are just like good. Next.
This one's from Jaina. Dog just figured out how to open the front door. Is this an act of God moment?
If you want to keep your dog alive, yes, it is. Next.
Stephanie, when first teaching place with e-collar, do you hold down button from time of saying command until they are in a down, or do you let up on stim once they are on mat?
Okay, Stephanie, first of all, people can watch the video to get the very minute details, but what you're doing is when we first teach place, leash guidance, remote pressure, dog lands on the mat, boom, let go. Then we do down separately. Got it? Then when the dog knows down on place and knows place, we put it together and we hold stim down until it's fully completed. Place and down, there's stim. Got it? So we don't say place down. It ends up just being place. Next.
Okay, this one's from Stephanie. Tips to keep dog from being collar wise with e-collar. She very quickly became collar wise with prong collar.
Use it a lot and use it with food, but I think you forgot the Leesboro 999999.
I just realized my questions went crazy, yep. So I'm going back to it. But for some reason.
So dog, I'll get it for you.
Right, dog afraid to hear. Head down, cower, submissive pee. Hmm. Guess first owner called him to punish him.
Yep.
Using prong inside, no distractions, lots of food. Ideas?
That's it right there. Clicker train the dog. Clicker train the dog. Recall the, have some fun. Recall the dog. Have the dog come to you. Put it in a sit. Click, reward. Woohoo, party time. All right. Or I'll tell you what. Don't use the word here. Use the word come or use another word. Literally make up a word. Make up a word that probably wasn't used. Not here, not come. Make up a word. Look at foreign words. Like, what's the French word for here? What's the Czech word for here? What's the Belgian word for here? Use another language here. What's the Spanish word for here? All right. Got it? Next.
This one's from Ray. Dog is fearful towards, however, when we're on a walk, she will break heel to sniff strangers. I hate to punish her for being curious towards people.
You're not punishing her for being curious towards people. You're punishing her for breaking heel. Imagine if she's off leash. What happens? She can go across the street. Also, who says strangers want to be sniffed by a dog? Right? So, no. Heel is heel. Heel is heel. I'm glad that she's being more curious and using her nose, but heel is heel. You can do that as a separate exercise. Don't confuse the dog. Next.
Van, quick tips on how to introduce dominant semi-aggressive base dog to other dogs. Put on muzzle and let all the dogs run around after leash introduction. The dog has a lot of structure, FYI.
So Van, when it comes to, like, there's no such thing as, what did you say? Semi-aggressive. No. That's like being like a semi-smoker or a semi-heroin user. You either smoke or don't smoke. Use heroin or don't use heroin. You're aggressive or not aggressive. Remember, aggressive dogs aren't aggressive with every single dog. You get into one dog fight out of 30, you're an aggressive dog. Because there's many dogs, unless you're attacked by a dog. But so what do you do? It's you. I wouldn't want there to be so, I would want to start it out really slow. There has to be a high correction for making a big mistake. Dogs on a muzzle. The last thing I want the dog to do is just be out there with a bunch of dogs without you for guidance. So we show a lot of it. If you watch the work we did with Logan, and we did a bunch of Facebook Lives with Logan, look for the Facebook Lives with Logan. We walk people through the process. That's almost like a Skype session. When it comes to biting dogs, we have to be very careful about just giving you casual advice. Next.
Anthony, you said that when a dog's forehead scrunches, it's never a good sign. What about when a dog's ears go up? When they are curious, no aggression there.
Okay. Not all scrunchy. Scrunchy, if you got a dog aggressive or dog reactive dog, the scrunch is a tell. So I'm not against dogs' forehead scrunching. I'm not against dogs' ears going up. We have to put my comments in context. All right. Yeah, it's important that you put comments in context. That's like saying, Jeff says he doesn't like dogs to play. During socialization, I don't, but I'm a huge advocate of play. You know, Jeff doesn't want dogs to pull. If we're doing weight pulling or tracking, yeah, I do. Or like mobility, I do. But for ears up, if the dog is leash reactive or aggressive, it's not a good sign. Curious depends what they're curious about and depends what the context is. Depends what the context is. Next.
This one's from Kion. Dog pulls ahead of heel no matter what. I've tried pre-punisher.
Yep.
What's that?
Just keep reading, please.
Okay. I've tried 180. Also, I want her to look at my damn heel instead of all around using prong collar.
Okay. So what I want you to do is this. Get the dog to go into follow mode. Follow mode. So you get the dog behind you. What I want you to do, your 180s might not be strong enough. Your pre-punisher might not be strong enough. You want to remote collar train the dog to proper heel. Also, the dog's walking. What you can do is you can take if your dog's walking on your left, take your left heel and just stick your foot out. Back this. You're not kicking your dog in the chest. Okay. The sternum is very, very powerful on a dog. Just go like that. All right, the dog ends up getting behind you. Got a couple of top chats from Mike. Want to take dog out ATVing protocol for dog to be comfy riding on it or heeling next to it at slow speeds like your bike rider protocol. Like my bike rider protocol, get the dog to place and then down on the ATV. Got it? With it off, then with it on, then with it, then riding with it. All right. Another $5 from Tony Cash. Tony Cash threw us $5 in cash. Thank you, Tony. Thank you. $4.99. Christina, rain all week in Southern California equals lots of place and duration work for Milo. Other tips for wet weather indoor work. Treadmill work, trick training, and just obedience commands. Running your dog around your house. So in other words, from like place to recall to down, go into next room, recall to place, you know, like little triangles. Next.
Did we do the collar wise one or did we not?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep. Oh, hold on. Another $4.99 top chat. Yeah. Zachary, people are noticing I'm not going to get to all the questions today. Going off on an earlier question, at what age would you transition to corrections for disobeying a known command if started at 14 weeks? When the dog is proficient, you're probably going to want to wait till 5 or 6 months. Next.
Okay, this one's from Steve. Your old GSD seems to be overly focused on my cell phone. I think it has to do with the light from it. What would you recommend to help this unwanted behavior?
So overly, could be curious. What's the dog do though? Like, what's the dog do? Is the dog attacking your cell phone? Is it attacking the cell phone? Or is it just like, hey, is that for me? Like, any of my buddies calling me? Hey, you just got a text. You want to read that to me? Or I don't know, maybe you're sexting and the dog's like, hey, I can use some fun right now. Or maybe they got like doggy Tinder out there. What I would do is, you know, I guess I need a little bit of more context on it. It's like the dog is focusing on it. Okay, well, if the dog was focusing on, say, you eating a sandwich, what would you do? Just a remote collar and say, hey, knock it off. And the dog goes from this to this. We see that all the time. So what you're doing is you're sort of like getting the dog to disengage. Next.
Melissa says, hi, Jeff and Mrs. Gellman.
Hey, hello. Melissa, how are you? Love you.
Jana, my dog submissively looks away when other animals and people look at her. Is there a way to give her more confidence?
Leave it alone. Leave it alone. Next. For that particular issue, leave it alone.
Melinda says, Laura, I don't know what Jeff is going to say to that, but I suggest a bonker.
Melinda, you want to join the fucking show? You want your own show, Melinda? Okay. Okay. Melinda's going to answer all the questions. Next.
Ray.
Yes.
Hey, Jeff, I listen to your training exclusively, and I have no problem with high-level punishment using prong and e-collar every day. However, I have been using the bonker for a week now, and now whenever I make any sudden movements, she always reacts and flees. Am I doing something wrong? Should I throw instead of club? Fearful.
Yeah.
Something.
Yeah. You should have been thrown in the first place. Watch the video on how to use a bonker. Lay off the bonker for a couple of weeks. Do more engagement. Dog come in there. But you shouldn't have to use a bonker that many times, guys. Guys, like if you're using a bonker every day, you're probably doing it wrong. Just for full clarity. Like it's like this is not something you do every day. Like the dog should understand it. And if the dog is always doing bad things, well, then you're not training it on the good stuff either. So that's what's happened. Don't worry about it. You didn't fuck your dog up. Take a step back, put the bonker away, train your dog tons of stuff you want it to do, and do lots of recalls to you with lots of rewards. Next.
This one's from Liz. Love your new RV. Will you install kennels in the bunk bed area or just dog beds there?
Liz, thank you so much. I didn't even show the bathroom or the bedroom either because I didn't have the photos because we're still finishing it off. So what I'm going to do with the bunk beds, the bottom bunk, is I'm going to just put a, it'll look like a crate. There'll be a door. The whole bottom bunk will be a door, and then there'll be a little opening, and then technically the bottom bunk will be a dog crate for the dogs. Next. The top one I'll probably end up leaving alone for storage, or if I don't think all three dogs can fit there, because they probably can't, excuse me, I'll do the same thing for up above, and I'll just have Tex. He can easily jump up to it. I'll either have him jump up to it or I'll just lift him up into it. Next.
This one's from Sam. Always look forward to the show. Both dogs in place while I'm watching and eating dinner. Thank you for all you do.
Awesome. Guys, anybody out there, feel free to always take the show, put it in your IG stories, put it on your Instagram and tag me. Also, definitely if you're watching it on TV, that's always really, really cool. Dog in place. The show's on the TV, get a photo, throw it up on your Instagram. Also, if you've not subscribed to our channel, make sure you subscribe to the channel. So subscribe below, hit your notification bell. Also, feel free to give us a thumbs up. Next.
Hey Dog says, love the hair color, Linda. Thank you very
much.
Always
got the hair color going on.
Kion, I'm moving into my parents' house for 6 months. They have 2 1-year-old golden doodles with basic obedience. However, they have never interacted with other dogs on their own property. My 6-month-old husky is very obedient. I consider myself a relatively skilled trainer. What is the protocol for introducing new dogs to a pack?
Okay, so it could be a shit show. So this is the thing. 6-month-old dog is going through some, it's going to be there from 6 months to a year, which is a pretty important growth period right there. What I would do is this, go for a walk. Go for a walk and then see how that goes. And then tons of structure. And I usually don't suggest this, but put a crate in your bedroom. Unless you've got a totally separate living area, like a separate apartment. But if it's a one family house and you're just taking up a bedroom, I normally don't suggest this. Put the crate right in your bedroom, unless there's a spare bedroom the dog can go in to sleep. But because I have no idea if your folks' dogs are, if they're on the same program as you. You sort of all got to be on the same program. So, but make sure there's no pack attack. Two high energy dogs against 1 6-month-old dog could be way too much. So advocate for the dog. Next.
You got a $5
chat. $5 chat there. From Susan, resource guarding of me by new pit bull female towards other female pit, 2 female dogs. Oh, shit show. Bad fight, discipline, household in place, suggestions. Yeah, do a Skype. Keep them separate right now. That's not the answer. That's not the fix. That's 2 female dogs, and now you've got power breed dogs. And the resource guarding, number one, cut down all affection. 0 affection for these dogs. Nobody gets affection. None whatsoever. Now, that's not going to fix it, but that's going to be part of it. All right? Crate the dogs. They should be in separate crates. Lots of structure. Right now, crate and rotate until we actually talk or until you find somebody that can work with you. Or you're going to end up with a dead dog or very expensive vet bills or one of the, and you're going to get injured. You're going to get injured. All right. And a lot of these dogs, some of these dogs just can't live together. Not because they're pits, just in general. Some dogs just don't go over it. We see a higher level of 2 females with that situation. Next.
This one's from Jaina. Any correction to crate whining results in escalation? What to do?
You're probably underwhelming the dog. So you want to maybe go higher or have the dog come out of the crate, correct there, put the dog back in. Also, how much duration work are you doing outside of the crate? And or is the dog always running around? Do you ever actually have the dog like do place for long periods of time? Then also have the dog go into the crate and do downs. With the door open, with the door closed when you are home. Next.
Jamal says, Linda, tell him what elusive is.
Thanks, Jamal. All right. Well, next time you come up
here. We already know I'm the intelligent one.
Okay. Next time you come up here, Jamal, when you're all done with all your chores, you and I will look at a dictionary together. Next.
That sounds like fun. Okay. Gary. Hi, Jeff. Using my furlough time since the government shut down for extra training time with dogs. Nice. Working on Leave It with 5-month-old puppy. So tough to walk a puppy. They want to pick up everything.
So, Gary, listen, fuck Leave It. Teach it no. And I'll tell you why. Do you really want your dog to leave stuff alone? Or do you want your dog to never pick up that stuff? So, no. But I would also say when you're walking your dog, if you walk in a proper heel with your dog's head up, how can it get stuff off the ground? I know they're quick. They're stealth-like. But if you got proper leash handling, right, and the dog only has so much leash, it can't put its head down or else it would correct itself. So think about those things. But I would use the word no instead of you always going leave it. Just do a good no. Next.
Jamal says that face was priceless. Did I make a face?
You always make a face.
I don't know what you're talking about. We got $5 here with a retracted message.
I don't know. That means we didn't get it. They were retracted. Uh-oh. It. Yeah, they probably heard the blowjob thing and fucking said, I ain't giving this guy money.
Ruh-roh.
I know.
This one's from Ray. I have an unfixed female. If I get a male dog, will they try to, oh, mate, can I control that?
Ray, yes, they most likely will. Okay. especially when the dog's in heat. Okay. Especially when the dog's in heat. So, let me tell you about, just a little sex ed. Ray, what the fuck? Don't you know how it happens? Yes. Yes. There'll be insertion and they'll be
Do
like,
you have to say insertion? Okay? That's so disgusting.
And they'll be like, and you can't get them apart. Next.
Oh my God. Okay. The greatest. Hi, the greatest. Mine and my sister's 12-week-old GSD puppies play fight too much and hurt each other. Should I stop it, or will they let each other know when it's enough? How do I stop it?
Okay, so they're obviously not stopping on their own, so you need to stop it. I would be super careful. You want to make sure you put massive structure in these dogs' lives. Sounds like they got a little bit too much freedom. So if they hurt each other, you've got to stop it. How do you stop it? Teach them no, use a bonker, have a leash on them. But I would make sure it's not a free for all at your house. So I'm not against play at all. Dogs should learn how to play. Dogs should learn how to play fight. But what I would do I want to make sure that is like 1% of the dog's day. 99% of that dog's day is a lot of other stuff, a lot of structure, a lot of training, all done with food. Next.
Karen. Hi, Jeff and Linda. For most non-life-threatening behaviors, is it best to try bonker before high e-collar corrections? Thanks.
Not necessarily. Bonker can work. I mean, remote collar is more practical sometimes. Next.
K9W, dog training. Client's one-year-old, two-pound dog, hates harness and shirt. She goes crazy and bites when trying to take it on and off. How to correct a small dog like this? I tried water spray bottle so far.
Two-pound dog? It's a year old and it's 2 pounds?
It's probably one of those little things.
Are you sure it's a freaking not a mouse? What the fuck is a two-pound dog? At 1 year old? So if I had a two-pound dog, I probably would call it dog food. would probably name it dog food.
You would not.
Yes, I would.
I wouldn't allow
I
it.
I would. I'd probably name it kibble.
It's a good name.
Kibble.
Kibble here.
So what I would do is this. If I had a two-pound dog that was trying to bite me when I had a shirt on, I probably would take my thumb and stick it right into its mouth. That's what I would do. Next.
Kyle, what exercise do you recommend beginning with for new board and trained dogs?
Exercise or training protocol, Kyle? So you want to know how we do our full program? You want to know what our full program is? I mean, I can tell you. Probably should do a Skype. That's what we do business consults for. But the first thing you want to do is in and out of a crate. How to go in out of a crate, how to go out of a crate. Then you can work on all your basic obedience commands. You work on your sit, your down, your place, your recall, your healing. You work on duration stuff. You work on then stopping unwanted behaviors. You work on all your structured exercise. So I'm not quite sure what your program looks like, but you can usually when the dog gets dropped off, it has to go into a crate. So doing crate protocols is a great first exercise. Great first exercise. But if you need help running your business, that's what I do. Actually, this is free. I actually make a living doing business consults. Actually, I'll be in Austin, Texas for 3 days on a nice business consult. Next week I leave. I think Wednesday I leave. We'll be documenting that whole journey, even though it's private. We have permission to document a lot of it. So that's what I would do. Next.
This one's from Carlin. How do I prevent my dog from barking and lunging at skateboards on a walk?
Well, you prevent it by stopping it. So you stop it. So the question is, how do you stop it? You stop it with, you role play it. Number one, teach your dog how to walk properly next to you without a skateboard. So without an environmental out there, you got to start somewhere. At least now, this is what I want you to do. So I want you to walk next to me. That's what I want you to do. Now, what do you do when the dog lunges? Well, prong collar on the dog, no pop. Whoa, that sucked. Yes, it did. But what you can do is you can get a skateboard with no rider. Just buy a skateboard, roll it. We do duration work, dogs in it down, dogs in place, skateboard. So now you're correcting for breaking place. You're correcting for breaking down. But when you're walking, you want to just see the arousal in the dog. The dog starts getting aroused around different environmentals, whether it's a skateboard or something else. That would be no and then correct. Next.
This one's from Jessica.
Oh, $5 top chat.
Oh, sorry.
Bo Boatner, why do you think dogs maul their owners? If genetics in a specific dog is not enough to prevent such an attack and training ensure full reliability? Bo, it's pretty rare that happens. It makes big headlines, but it's very, very rare that it happens. Why do dogs maul their owners? You know, that's when I, you know, it's, is it genetics? It could be. You know, I've worked with dogs that have bitten their owners severely. We work with them and they don't go after us. So it could be relationship. It could be relationship. Why does the dog do it? Because it feels like it can. So just think about that for a minute here. It feels like it can. Most dogs won't start a fight that they don't think they could win. Okay? Dog wants to go home at the end of the day as well. So if a dog feels too much pressure, it might have to fight, right? If it's like you're putting pressure on it. But for a dog to maul an owner, continuously bite and bite and bite, even when the owner is like on the ground and not stop, you know, to me, I wouldn't keep that dog. I wouldn't rehab that dog. I'd be like, why? Why do you want to spend money on that? We're not talking about a dog bite. We're talking about a mauling. So let's all put this into context. Jeff, did you just say to kill a dog? Yes, I did. Damn right I fucking did. That dog shouldn't be walking the face of the earth. Now, could it be rehabbed? We could give it a shot if you wanted to, but are you, the maulee, going to ever feel comfortable with that dog? Most likely not. You'll probably have PTSD. So I've been mauled before, and it was not fun. So, you know, this is early in my career when my skill set wasn't there, and I was working dogs above my pay grade. You know, so now it won't happen because we take so many, like none of us are getting bit anymore because we take incredible safety protocols and our skill sets have gotten so damn good. So, you know, could it happen? Sure it could. But yeah, that's hard to come back from an owner. Dogs, a lot of dogs don't get a second chance, and maybe they don't deserve one. Maybe they don't deserve one. You know, getting bit by a dog is one thing. Mauled, that's a whole nother level. Next.
This one's from Jessica.
Wait, hold on, Melinda. It's another top chat. Yeah, they're all looking similar. Love you guys. My bonker suggestion was for the husband that said he wanted his wife to behave in Vegas. I leave the dog stuff to you. Thank you, Melinda. Thanks for the clarification. You could still do your own show if you want to. Most of my super fans could. They already know the answers. It's funny because a lot of the super fans here, they already know the answers to the question. Next.
Okay, this one's from Jessica. My dog went through a board and train. You actually met Jax at Josh and Julie's. I can't seem to stop him from low growling as my guests enter the house. I correct high, he whimpers, low growls again. Correct high. This cycle continues for about 3 high corrections, yep. And then he gives up. Any suggestions on how to stop that low growl cycle? I'm not correcting high enough.
Try the bonker. You might not be correcting high enough, but also give Josh and Julie a call. Just give them a call. Find out what they did that worked for them. And see if they can help you out. But yeah, you might be underwhelming your dog. Next. Loose skin. Next.
Hey, dog. When my dog sees a stranger walking in our direction, minding their own business, he often freezes and stares. Correct? I've been letting them pass by, and he doesn't react other than the stop and stare.
Yeah, correct. Correct for that. Yep.
LN? Yeah. How do I... Oh, you scrolled?
Yeah, I scrolled too
far. How do I stop my dog from growling? I've been bonking him every time he growls at noises, but then he continues if he keeps hearing it. Keep bonking?
No, don't keep bonking. You're probably not bonking firm enough. I would use a prong collar correction or remote collar correction. Next.
This one's from Victoria.
I'm way off here.
Been working with dogs on prong collar while walking. GSD does great now. My pit was doing good, but when we are outside, he focuses on everything but me. He does great inside. Do I add another tool?
What's the tool that you're using? I lost the question.
On prong.
Yeah, you can add remote collar and teach remote collar focus.
She also says he isn't pulling me yet, but he is leading, sniffing, searching, barking at squirrels. I correct him. He doesn't care.
I know, because he's already in drive. He's already in drive. So you missed it. You missed it. You're too far. Get him back. Don't let him do any of that behavior. Guys, don't let your dogs out front do what they want, even if they're calm, and then be surprised that you can't control them when they start getting out of control. You've already let them go too far. Get them back. Get them in a whole other state of mind, which is follow. $4.99 top chat. Caitlin, my one-year-old pit mix will go after any dog starts reversed. How would you suggest I address this? My one-year-old pit mix will go after any dog. The next part I don't do. How would you suggest I address this directly? That's a very, very long answer, Caitlin. And what I would do right now is make sure you got the proper tools on your dog. Muzzle your dog up, please. Your dog should always be on leash. This isn't going to fix it, but it's going to stop you from, you know, a dog fight and you having to put down your dog. Make sure you've got proper tools. Prong collar is going to help empower you. Remote collar training is going to help empower you. Watch our videos on proper healing. You'll start there. start there, but you want to be consuming massive amounts of our content. It's not just one thing. We have a full comprehensive training philosophy that we do. It's not just about like stopping unwanted behaviors. It's about literally how to live with your dog. Next.
This one's from Ray. Does it make sense to punish a dog for running away when recalled, like 2 minutes after I catch her? No more off leash for her.
No, you fucked up. So no, keep her on a leash. Next.
This one's from Rachel. While walking my leash reactive dog, aggressive Pyrenees, and barking dog ran up behind us, and she didn't even look or come out of heel. Thank you for all the advice and
holy
motivation.
Shit. Okay, that's awesome. That's fucking impressive. Next.
Susan, resource guarding of me between two pit bull females. New dog attacked other female. I'm not having it.
We did that already.
Did we really do that same exact one?
That was a top chat. Right. Yep.
Alyssa, how do you suggest beginning crate training with an older dog, introducing them to the crate? I can't talk anymore. How long would it take to integrate the e-collar for barking?
So two separate questions. The first question is, how do you introduce it for crate training? It's 9 p.m. It's bedtime. Go in your crate. I'll see you in the morning. That's how you do it. Literally, that's how you do it. Any nonsense, tell the dog to be quiet. That's what we do. That's how I do. That's the most practical thing for families. This 10 minutes at a time, 30 minutes at a time, 1 hour at a time, bullshit. Like, when do we sleep? When do we work? So you don't do that. As far as using the remote collar for barking, e-collar for barking, get yourself a bark collar for the dog. Goes off automatically. Next.
This one's from Elizabeth.
Hey, Elizabeth.
When doing place, do you put the dog anywhere? Would you place the dog in its kennel for the place command?
No, place that would be kennel command. Place is on a dog mat, dog bed, carpet square. It's on an object. Next.
This one's from Lou. Can a high stim correction escalate a reactive dog's behavior instead of stopping it?
Absolutely. It absolutely can fuel the fire. That's because you underwhelm the dog. That does absolutely happen. Next.
Victoria says, tried walking with Bonker. He would back up, but immediately jump ahead again.
You can't really walk with your Bonker because you can't bonk in public because everyone will shy away from that. Bonker is more used for just one and done, guys. One and done. So Bonker isn't a replacement for all these other tools that we have. So, you know, I would have your dog again on proper equipment, on a prong collar, remote collar, train your dog how to heel properly. The bonking is not something you do like, guys, you shouldn't be bonking your dogs continuously day in and day out, or you're probably using it wrong. You're probably using it wrong. So usually once you bonk for one thing, one or two times, that's probably all you're going to have to do. So bonking is not like, you know, a leash pop. It's like every time you leash pop, you wouldn't be bonking. So it's used in a different way. Next.
This one's from Anthony. Black Lab gets a ton of exercise on 4 acres of land, runs for at least an hour every morning and afternoon on the ski, something, but was still hyper until we started bonking. That calmed him right down.
Good. Also, yeah, do duration work. Guys, more exercise does not equal calm dog. More exercise means in shape dog. You still want to teach duration work. So right now I've got 3 high drive dogs. For everybody that can't see this or this on my sound platforms, if you're visually impaired, I apologize. I'm holding the camera up to 3 of my dogs right now. Okay. All high drive working line dogs, all with incredible drive. Right now, if I told them to break, they would fucking just go literally like, you want to go 20 miles? Let's go 20 miles. You want to go all night? Let's go all night. Seriously. But no, what do? They come in here. Boom, they do nothing. Because what else would they do? Because they've always done nothing in this office. They always do nothing when they're in place. They immediately go into a calm state of mind and lie down. It's not because I'm a dog trainer. It's because I just practice what I preach. Next.
This one's from Anil. Greetings from Northern California. Puppy is intact and started marking. He is now going in random places inside the house on scheduled walks, but still had accidents inside. Any tips? Thanks again.
Yeah, I'm going
to
be up in San Francisco. Don't forget Jeff Gellman Seminars, jeffgellmanseminars.com. So what I would do is, this is what I would do. You can't let your eyes off the dog. The dog always has to be there. I mean, you have to always be with your dog right now. Don't let it walk around free. That's what you have to do. You can catch the dog in the act. You can correct. But you're better off putting the dog on an outdoor schedule. And then where are you? Where's the human? Next.
Kyla, Used bonker twice this week for first time on 15-month-old GSD. Tonight, dog broke place. I said no, stood up. She went running fast to place, slid into a shelf like I was going to hit her. Normal reaction to bonker?
Well, I mean, it sounds like the dog understands the word no, right? So used bonker twice this week for first time on 15-month-old German Shepherd. The dog broke place. She said no, stood up. She went running fast back to place, slid into the shelf. Yeah, I mean, the dog slid into the shelf just because it was moving so fast. Yeah, like you taught your dog not to break place and to go back there. That's sort of what you want to do. We don't want them sliding into shelves, but your dog was like, holy shit, I better get my ass back there. Yeah, sounds about right. Next.
This one's from Rob. Hey, guys, do you use raised place beds for a specific reason? More airflow, easier to clean under dogs can't hang off the edge. Trying hard to guess the answer. I love that little emoji there.
Yes.
Wondering if worth the cost.
It's because we can stack them and we can disinfect them and hose them down very easily. And they're easy to store. They're easy to store. That's why. And it's raised up. It does make it easier to send a dog to it. But we just do it more because it's the training center. Like at home, I don't have raised. Like my dogs are on dog beds right now. $5 from Justine. Mm-hmm. How do you stop three dogs from charging front door when it is knocked on, training individually? Will the two cause the one being trained to react? Yeah. But right now, yeah, all three have to be on a leash. What you can do is, believe it or not, here we go with the bonker again. You say no, whiz it at the door. You whiz it at the door. But yeah, all three need to be on the same page. So start, but I would start with that. Just you make it suck. You might need a couple of bonkers. No, boom, boom, boom. Get away from the front door. Next.
This one's from Paige. Hey, I'm going to be getting a Labrador puppy in early June. Top five tips for puppy training?
Get a book, number one. So buy yourself a puppy, How to Raise a Puppy book. Monks of New Skeet makes a good one. And then also Caesar makes a good one, believe it or not. And then there's a couple of other people that make a good one. Massive amounts of structure. That's the number one tip right there. Potty schedule and massive structure. Tons of food training. Teach the dog with the word yes is and no. Don't put up with unwanted behaviors such as biting and jumping. Next.
This one's from Victoria. Also, I don't want either dog on the couch. When we are up, both dogs know place and stay there until we break them. However, at night, when we sleep, they jump on the couch and we find them there in the AM.
So they break out of their crates and jump up on the couch? They got skills.
Oh, you're funny.
Well, you know, I mean, you'd have to crate your dogs, number one. Number two, if you don't want to crate your dogs, then have remote collars on them, set up a video camera right at the couch, wait for the dog to get up on the couch, make it suck. Dog stays off the couch. Is that guaranteed every night while you're sleeping and you're not watching your dogs? Maybe, maybe not. I would just crate my dogs. Next.
This one's from Ms. Tin. 6-month-old Doxy whines in the morning and late afternoon to be let out from 30 minutes to 45 minutes before time. We let her out morning, lunch, and late afternoon for a play and walk. How to stop the whining?
Well, do you let her out to go to the bathroom too? So, because that could be separate. How do you stop whining? You stop whining through proper application of punishment. So remote collar stops whining. So no, and then stop whining with a remote collar. You can use a leash correction for that if you want to. So, you know, if the dog's doing it every day and the dog doesn't have to go to the bathroom, it's just being a pain in the butt. So whining is stopped through applying a punisher. Next.
This one's from Kira. Dog humped me and my partner bonked the shit out of her. Thanks for the advice.
Okay. Hopefully just bonked it, not bonked the shit out of her. Next. Yeah, but a dog humping a human can be a very dangerous situation. Next.
You got a top chat.
Top chat, $5. James, 2-year-old shelter dog, good with all people and pets except scared of my dad. He comes to him when he's seated or has treats, but is still shaking and scared. Have your dad take him for, and it doesn't make a difference, he's a shelter dog. Okay, he's a dog. Shelter dog. Shelter's not a breed. Rescue's not a breed. Because I know why people say that, because you don't know the dog's history, and the history doesn't matter. So if he comes up to him and takes treats, he's nervous. He's not that nervous because he takes food. So have your dog do more engagement stuff with him. Train him. Have your dog train him. Take him for walks. Play with him. Things like that. Next.
Susan, fight between two pit bull females after... Didn't we read one just like
yes. this? Yes.
Is it the same person?
Yep. Same one. Yep. Okay.
Stephanie, first time watching your lives. I'm loving this. You guys rock.
Oh, awesome, thank Stephanie. You. We're on again Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, Saturday night, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Next.
This one's from Margaret. How do I get my dog to not flip out on other dogs? As soon as she sees them, she is in the red zone.
Margaret, a lot of the suggestions that we've already given right now and that are on my YouTube channel as well. And what you're going to do is start out with proper tools and make your life easier. Prong collar, minimum, get a prong collar for your dog, size it, fit it proper, introduce it to the dog, teach your dog how to properly heel next to you. Start with that. That might organically just stop it right there. Then if you start seeing your dog breaking heel, you correct for breaking heel. Start with that, and then we'll move on from there. Next.
This one's from Melvin. What's the point of the vibrate mode on e-collars? What is it good for? Can it be used for punishment? Thank you so much. You guys are the best.
Anything can be used for punishment. If you do vibrate, I don't use vibrate. Because vibrate, you can't go up or down. It's the same vibrate. No matter what number it's on, it's the same stim. A lot of dogs don't feel it. And some dogs, when they feel vibrate, it's too much. Can it be used for punishment? Anything can be used for punishment. If the dog doesn't like it, it's a punisher. So we just don't use it. Next.
The greatest. What can I train a 12-week-old dog? She knows sit, lay down, break, place, kind of, wow. Door boundaries. I'd like to show her stop pulling on leash and come, but was told her brain isn't ready for that.
Well, recall the damn dog's brain is always ready for that because it's coming to you for food. So take the dog's daily kibble and keep it in a little food pouch on you. And what you do is you do shitloads of recall. That's how it eats. Brain's not ready for that. What dog doesn't run to you for food? Of course the brain's ready for that. 6 weeks. How many little puppies have you seen freaking chase after their mother's titties? Give me a break. Of course the dog's ready for that. Whoever told you that doesn't know what the fuck they're talking about. So no, I would do lots of weeks. You know, puppy's name here and puppy comes to you. Good. Tell it to sit. Boom. Take the kibble, put it on the ground, and then you run away, whatever, 10 feet. Dog's done eating the kibble. Puppy here. Runs to you. Oh, yeah. Do tons of that. Next.
Crixus. Hey, Jeff and Linda. Love you guys. Been working hard on training with great results. Thanks for all your help.
Thumbs up. Awesome.
John, I'm going to teach my dog commands only in Scandinavian Viking dog. Mwahaha.
It's true. Yeah. You know, I know a couple of trainers that have done that. Next.
Horse Crazy.
Oh, hey, what's up?
I haven't seen Horse Crazy in a while. I have an 8-year-old dog and have become frustrated. When outside, he doesn't listen. 3/4 of the time, I'm struggling with taking forever on wanting to mark the whole yard.
To go to the bathroom?
Oh, this is part one. Hold on. When I say come, he ignores me. I have to go off porch to get him. What would you suggest for me to do to get him to listen?
Horse Crazy, train your dog recall. The dog's not going to just come back to you. Train the dog actually how to come back on command and make sure the dog is proficient. And it's all done on leash at first. Next.
Margaret, I love watching you guys.
Thanks, Boy, Margaret. Thank you. We love having you watch.
Tony, my dog's neck bleeds from the e-collar. I hear you talk about pads for them. Where can I buy the pads for the e-collar?
Huh, you might have it on too long in the same spot for too much. That's unusual. Comfort pads. Go to ecollar.com. Ecollar.com. Next.
Michelle says late, but here. Hi, Jeff and Linda.
Hey, Michelle. Hi. How are you?
Simon, I'm waiting for a solid canine all black bonker to come out. Let's make it happen. I will buy.
Simon, go to Walmart. Go to the towel section.
Buy a black towel.
Buy a black towel. Next. Russ says, good evening.
Wait, where did you see that?
Right there.
Did I skip it?
Yep, don't worry about it. Hold on. Leesboro 999. Just says it's a $2 top chat. They don't show up.
Oh, shiznit.
Thank you, building confidence. Now, Jillian.
We have that worked out. Okay. Yes. Hey, guys, really struggling with the GSD whine. Happens when he's on place. If I correct at home, he stops when visiting friends' houses and he's on place. He won't give it up. We use an e-collar.
So he's more aroused. He's more aroused there. Make sure you say no first and then do stim. And you're going to have to work him through it at the friend's house. You might have to go at higher levels. You might have to do it at lower levels. You might have to do nick. You might have to do continuous. You might have to go over there and bonk. Like, you might have to give a leash pop. Like, you're going to have to be creative. Next.
Okay. I'm not sure which question was Steve's, but he says he will try to take it from me.
I don't know.
Bonker. I don't know. These next two, we've done these already.
Yep. I know. What happens is taking so long to get through the questions, people are asking again.
Yeah.
But guys, we're overloaded with questions. We can only get to so many. It's a, you know, and that's a problem with being a free show too.
James.
Hold on. Stephanie did a $1.99 top chat.
I didn't see it.
6-2-week-old Doberman. When should I expect better focus? If you do all food training right now, you'll get it next.
Okay. James, I got my dog from a shelter a year ago. He is very good with all people and animals, but has been deathly afraid of my father's.
We did this one. Yep.
People are asking. That's cool though. Thanks for asking again in case we miss it. Yep. Be healed, dog training. Oh my God, I had this awful lingering cough from a cold. Laughing irritates it. You can't say things like you can't say insertion.
I can say
you're
insertion.
Sending me into coughing fits. Insertion is a.
When did I say insertion? Oh, when we're talking about
a dog being in heat.
Yeah, dogs are being in heat. It freaking the dog's penis gets inserted. And a lot of
stop saying it.
A lot of insertion. Well, from what I understand, she was recently inserted.
What?
Because I think she's pregnant again.
Who?
Be healed dog training. She's very familiar with insertion. Next.
Mel.
Yep.
How can I stop excited peeing in a 6-month-old Rottweiler puppy?
Oh, God. It's easier to stop biting, Mel. It's a pain in the ass. That's for sure. Massive amounts of – this is how we do it. We just got – I'll tell the story on Wednesday, I think, of the dog that we got in that freaking pisses a damn ocean every time you look at it. It just came in last week. It's been I never saw so much pee come out of a dog in my life. Do our whole training program, and the shrapnel effect is the dog doesn't have excitement pee. Pretty much no loud voices, no excited voices, no loud voices. Everything is calm, massive amounts of structure, and watch the affection. That's for starters.
This one's from James. Treats and other, I don't know what this goes.
It goes to the father.
Treats and other things, and it helps temporarily, but then we're right back to him running away and shaking at the sight or sound of my father.
So something about your dad freaks out the dog. Something about your dad freaks out the dog. So if you really want to fix this, have your dad spend a shitload of time with the dog, working the dog. Next.
Kindness matters. My young dog just started growling and barking at children. How should I go about addressing this?
Correct it. Anytime you want to stop, you correct it. So we would do a leash correction. We would do a bonker. We would use a remote correction. Anything like that, that's how we stop unwanted behaviors. Next.
I don't know what someone's saying about reverse sneezing. Did I miss something?
I don't know, but get right to...
Sorry, that starts reverse sneezing. I don't know what that means. Yeah. Shayna, can I use a prong collar on a 3-month English bulldog?
12 weeks old. Wait 2 to 3 more weeks. Next.
Mr. Robert, greetings. Have a super nervous dog which poops when sees strangers. Any suggestions? Thanks. Oh, that's the worst.
That's a hard one. What I would do right now is it's we've seen some of those dogs, massive amounts of structure. You can't stop a dog from taking a shit. So massive amounts of structure, a lot of confidence building. I can't stress massive amounts of structure and cut out any affection right now. It sounds cold and uncaring. And just work the dog. And then don't let strangers approach the dog. Get the dog around lots of people. Next.
Jesus. Hi, Jeff. My 10-month-old dog will not go to the bathroom outside on the leash. We have to take him to the backyard after walks. We go walking with his sister, and she has no trouble going to the bathroom on walks.
Well, it's a different dog. That's why. Well, hold on. Are you talking about the same dog? We go walking with his sister. She has no problem going to the bathroom on the walk. Is you talking about your sister? The dog has no problem, or your sister's dog. Either way, what do? First thing in the morning, put the dog on the leash and go to... You go outside, go to one potty spot. The dog goes to the bathroom. You mark it with good or use a clicker and give food. Next.
This one's from Gary. My dog shies when he's on leash if I scuff my foot. How do I overcome his fear?
Wow. So when he's on a leash, if I scuff your foot. So I don't know what that's from, obviously. How do you do it? Get your dog on a leash. And I would have your dog like in a down or in place and scuff your feet a lot. And the dog doesn't move, reward, and mark it with a clicker and reward. Next.
This one's from Rach. Linda looks like a punk rocker chick with the beanie. Cool.
She is. Oh, that's thanks. Why.
Punk punk rock mom.
Yeah.
Shayna. I have a problem with middle-aged male client I just did a consult with. I asked if 6 p.m. is okay. He said, yes, I'll even cook you dinner. I said, thanks, but no thanks. When I get there, ask me if I want wine and cheese. What is this, J-date?
Yeah, so it sounds like it. I mean, free food. When I used to go to people's homes, I used to be an at-home dog trainer. That's when I started out. I got fed extremely well.
You gained weight too.
I got fed really, really well. So next.
So I didn't have to feed you.
Right.
Elizabeth says, thank you, Jeff and Linda. Thank you, Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, thank you.
Look who's on. Good pup Wellesley.
Heather, look at you.
Hillary.
Hillary. Did I say Heather?
Yeah.
Hillary. That's how long it's been. I forgot your name, Hillary.
Hello,
I just saw your video with your three dogs running. They're running around today.
I see it all the time.
Yeah, what were they doing? What was it though? I forgot what they were doing. Next.
They're so cute. Yes. I didn't even read what she said.
Sorry.
Hello, my old friends. Looking great. Like the violet hair and the beard.
Oh, thanks.
Who's got the beard though?
I'm making an Italian joke.
Oh, funny. Horse Crazy says, sorry, I have missed you guys. Haven't been getting notified when you're live.
Huh.
Did you click the thing to get your notifications?
Yeah, hit your notifications. I don't know why. Maybe their settings are off. Next.
Justine, I think that's how you say it. My female pit bull always barks at Bonker, and today she managed to chew up the Bonker. Is a Bonker going to be effective for her?
I would say, how the heck did your dog get a Bonker? It should be out of sight, out of reach, right? That's something that we use as just a training tool, as a punisher. So human error. Next.
Tony, thank you, Jeff, for the answer. You guys are awesome. Listen to you guys all the time.
Thanks, Tony.
Thank you.
Next.
Shayna, I'm creeped out by this guy. He keeps texting me saying I'm the only one he trusts.
Okay. So Shayna, you don't have to keep going. Shayna, it's time to break the relationship off.
Mm.
So it's like, you know what? I'm like, this is unprofessional. It's not acceptable. And I can no longer be your dog trainer. And you give him a refund back. All right. And then you block his number. Next.
Mm. James says, hey, sorry for the double question. I did it as a top chat the second time, so I made sure I didn't miss your answer. You're the best.
Yeah, no problem at all, James. Yep.
Kilgore at Sheena Carlson. Stay away, period. Stay away. Yep. Uh-huh.
Kilgore, you think? Great advice. I'm surprised Melinda didn't just chime in.
Be healed dog training. Yeah. Jeff, you did not. Linda, I think you need to keep a Bonker close by to keep him in line.
I did not what? Next.
Probably some of your sassy talk.
Oh.
Mel H., you say structure. Can you be specific? He has the same schedule every day. Eats same times, walks same times. I keep as close as possible for training schedule. We are working with a new trainer.
Sounds about right. Yeah, that's structure. Next.
Jesus says, thanks for the answer. You two rock.
Jesus, you're welcome.
I'm at the end here.
Good. We're out of time. Is that it?
Oh, wait. Aria?
Yep.
Thank you for talking about so many great things. You've really helped my training with my dog, Tucker.
Woo! Well, you went right at an hour and 12. You only do an hour show. Mm-hmm. All right, guys. That's it. We're done. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. Make sure you go to solidcaninetraining.com, solidcaninetraining.com. What I would also do is you go to our Instagram channel, watch us on IG stories. On IG stories, if you go there, there is a sticker. There's one of the stories that you can do an AMA. Ask me anything. You can ask a question in there. Jump onto my Patreon channel. I make a Patreon video every week. Actually, last week's video is going up tonight, right after the show. I'm going to put it up. You can do that. Go to Jeff Gellman Seminars. Also, if you want to buy some merchandise, coffee mugs, t-shirts, you go to whatwouldjeffdo.com.
Don't forget your pop socket.com.
Get yourself a pop socket. Get yourself a sticker. All right. All right. Yeah, James, you probably want to do and Skype. You go to my Skype. Go to my website for Skype. God, a lot of these questions need to be done in long format, guys. A lot of them have to be in long format. Aggression, long format. Anxiety, long format. Hopefully though that people picked up helpful protocols and tips from like the whole body of work of this, but also consume our videos. All right, guys, I'm madly in love with you. Don't forget, hug your kids, train your dog. Love you. Bye-bye.